Please tell me your name, your job title, and your company name.
So my name is Tim Weinigs. I'm Vice President of Sales and Marketing for Pipeline Packaging.
And how many sales managers report to you?
So I have currently 4 sales managers reporting to me, along with a director of marketing and a marketing analyst.
On a scale of 1 to 10, how happy are you with your sales pipeline visibility?
I'm pretty happy with the visibility. We've implemented Salesforce.com, so I've got, total visibility into what we're doing. I may not be happy with some of the quality of leads that are in there, but we're working on enhancing the sales skills and properly qualifying and continue to fill that pipeline.
What was the topic of your last sales meeting?
Our last sales meeting we had in January, we always have our annual sales meeting, and at that meeting it was all about training. So we had training on our Kale sales system, where our sales team members presented various aspects of the training system to show the other team members how they've implemented into their territory management. We trained on Salesforce.com, which is a kind of an ongoing process because we've only been at Salesforce for about a year and a half. And sometimes we're a little too reliant on the technology and not the people portion of it. And there's some older sales team members that aren't as technologically astute. And so adoption is a challenge. And so again, continuing to train and educate on that tool is a necessity.
What did you hope to learn at the Sales 3.0 conference today?
So, I'm of the belief, the old adage, you're either growing or dying. And so we were just looking for new best practices in terms of how people are running their sales organizations and hoping to pick up on some technologies. But I think one of the insights that I came away with, I was looking for more technology, and what I've learned is enablement's probably more important. They can use the tools as kind of an arrow in their quiver, but they really have to know how to shoot. And so I think I'll be able to come away now with a few options for sales enablement, and we're looking to really train our people on the critical skills needed to sell effectively, and then just augment that with technology.
Who was your favorite speaker today?
My favorite speaker today, far and away, was the gentleman that spoke about artificial intelligence.
Victor Antonio.
Victor Antonio. Absolutely fantastic. His energy, his insight, his sense of humor, and the topic is one of extreme interest for me, because I think leveraging the whole artificial intelligence platform going forward as it evolves as a technology is going to be critical to success.
Does anything scare you about artificial intelligence in selling?
Yeah, I think, there's always the scary side about artificial intelligence in terms of where it can go, job displacement, maybe working in the wrong direction. Come on through.
Hi.
But no, I think that like any new technology, I'm always exciting, and I like to get out on the bleeding edge, so I think I'm more excited than scared.
Okay, great. Hi, come on through.
Hi.
That's okay. Hello. You're part of my video. What is one thing that you hope to accomplish before the end of the day today?
So by the end of the day today, I'm going to go back and make a couple of vendor connections so that I can get some follow-up presentations and some more insight into the services they provide.
What would you say to anyone considering coming to a Sales 3.0 conference?
I would say it's an absolute must. If you're interested in learning, if you're interested in finding out what's going on in the sales world, if you're interested in new technologies and best practices and ideas, it's just continuing to learn and find out what your peers and what's going on in the industry.
Tell me one thing you're excited about in the next 3 to 6 months.
I'm excited about implementing a sales enablement strategy for our company so that we can further train and develop our team. It resonated with me that, you know, the differentiator for us is our human capital. And so really developing those folks is going to be critical for our success going forward.
Terrific. Thank you so much.
Thank you.